if anybody having any question from the first lecture, so now it's the time to ask. Is any question from your side if you have? Yes. So hopefully you have gone through the slides that I have sent to you. I could not send the recording, so I will try that this week. I will send the previous recording and the recording of this week as well, hopefully at the end of this week. So you should then be able to go through the recording as well. So how many of you have gone through the slide that I have sent to you, the slides of the first lecture, and also have shared the slides of the second lecture for this week also? कितने लोगों ने पढ़ने की कोशिश की है, डाउनलोड किए हैं? ओनली वन अप टिल नाउ, और भी हैं? ये जस्ट डाउनलोड किए हैं, पढ़ी भी हैं? जो भी कितने लोगों ने इसमें इनमें से पढ़ी हैं ताकि मैं क्वेश्चन वगैरह पूछूं? सिर्फ छह लोग हैं जिन्होंने पढ़ी हैं या उनको देखा स्लाइड्स को, तो बाकी लोग क्या कर रहे हैं? ओके, यू शुड ऑल ऑफ यू शुड डाउनलोड दो स्लाइड्स. अगर किसी की नहीं डाउनलोड हो बताएं, सबकी डाउनलोड उम्मीद हो रही होगी. अगर इश्यू है तो बता सकते हैं, डिस्कस कर सकते हैं. एनी हाउ, सो ऑल ऑफ यू शुड डाउनलोड द स्लाइड्स ऑफ लेक्चर वन एंड टू, गो थ्रू देम. एज आई मेंशनड, रिकॉर्डिंग जो है बाद में उम्मीद है इस वीक में शेयर कर दूंगा दोनों की, उसको भी आप लें ताकि जो भी क्वेश्चन वगैरह आपके हैं उससे रिलेटेड उसको जो है टेकअप किया जा सके, उसके आंसर दिए जा सके. बिकॉज इन ऑडियल क्लासेज, ऑनलाइन क्लासेज, इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज दैट यू शुड यू अंडरस्टैंड द थिंग दैट वी हैव डिस्कस. और उसका यही होता है कि आप क्वेश्चन पूछें और उससे पता चलेगा आपने पढ़ा है और जो चीज़ समझ नहीं आती उसका आंसर किया जा सके. So try to be more active in the subject and try to complete the task whatever assigned to you, so that you understand the things better, you have the better understanding of the topics or the subject. Okay, so as I mentioned in our first week's lecture, we started with the introduction and also our first topic, that was elementary hydrodynamics. So in elementary hydrodynamics, we discussed first of all what is elementary hydrodynamics, that is study of the fluid mechanics phenomena based on mathematical terms or based on the mathematics, developing or deriving the equation and then defining the parameters like continuity. We will do today rotational, irrotational flow, vorticity, etc., and then further certain other things will be discussed. We discuss one-dimensional flow in which one velocity component is taken to define completely the flow field. In two-dimensional flow, like flow at the entrance of pipe, flow at the exit, flow at the convergence and divergence of channels. So we have two velocity components to consider, and three-dimensional flow. In reality, all the flows are three-dimensional, but there are cases where three-dimensional flows are important to be considered, and the three components of the velocity are important to define completely the flow field. Three-dimensional flow we also discussed last time. The main thing that we discussed that was taught to you was the differential equation of continuity. So considering a three-dimensional element, differential element of the fluid, considering three-dimensional, three mutually perpendicular axes and correspondingly the velocity components along these axes, we derive the three-dimensional continuity equation. Firstly, for general case, that was equation number 8, and then further we reduce it to steady flow, and then finally to the incompressible fluid. So for steady incompressible fluids, that is the case that we consider for, we will take for this topic. Partial u or partial x plus partial v or partial y plus partial w partial z is equal to 0. So the three dimensional continuity equation in two dimensional form, eliminating one dimension, that is z direction. So we have the partial u or partial x plus partial v or partial y is equal to 0 as a two dimensional continuity equation. So So these are things that we have that we discussed last time. We also applied the equation, two-dimensional quantity equation, to check the two-dimensional flow fields to be continuous or not. So we have checked them. The first one came out to be continuous, following the continuity equation or satisfying the continuity equation. We also checked the second one, which was not continuous, and the third one was the continuous flow field. Then we also discussed the definitions of rotational and irrotational flow. Irrotational flow is the one where the elements of the fluid, they rotate, but their net algebraic rotation or average rotation is zero. Example is Ferris wheel, and in rotational flow, there is net rotation of the element also lesser than the one in irrotational flow, but you can say net rotation is not zero. When the element rotates, so it occupies the rotated position. It does not come back to its original position or with respect to original frame of reference. So this is an example given that in case of irrotational flow, an element of the fluid, the axis of the element of the fluid will move towards or away from each other with equal amount, alpha and beta is same. And at the next time interval, maybe moment, it will come to its original position or original upright position. In case of rotational flow, this element of the fluid is rotated after some time t, delta t, and this is now the final position of the element with respect to this time, or it will not come back to its this original shape. It will further continue to rotate about a certain axis. So that is the rotational flow. Now, next thing, in continuation of that, how mathematically we can define the rotational and irrotational flow, that we'll discuss further today, and we'll try to complete this topic. Now, considering a small two-dimensional fluid element, if you look at the figure, so we are given with two-dimensional fluid element A, B, C, D, and it is at this position at any time t. So there is a fluid element A, B, C, D, which is present at any time t in the given position. Now, at any time t plus delta t, or after elapsing time delta t, this element has rotated counterclockwise, you can say. So now this face AB becomes A dash B dash, and the side CD becomes C dash D dash, and the angle between side AB and A dash B dash is delta alpha. So it means that this is the element at time t, and this is the element, same element at time t plus delta t when it is rotated. So now mathematically we have to define what is rotational flow and what is irrotational flow. In the part B of this figure 5.3, the two positions of the same element at time t and at time t plus delta t, they are superimposed. For example, this is the position of the element at time t, A, B, C, D. And now this is dotted is the position of the element at time t plus delta t when there is angle delta alpha between A, B and A dash B dash side, and there is angle delta beta between AD and A dash D dash side. Now, the element has delta X dimension on X axis and delta Y dimension on Y axis. Further, the movement or the distance covered of the element from B to B dash, from point B to B dash, this is the distance covered by the element. And this is equal to velocity in this direction, it is velocity in y direction at this point multiplied by the time. You know that distance is equal to velocity is equal to distance over time. So distance is equal to velocity multiplied by the time over which that change has occurred. So the element has moved from B to B dash with an angle delta alpha from the original line aside. And how much distance it has moved, that is the velocity at this point of the element multiplied by the delta t, the time over which this movement has taken place. Now, what is the velocity at this point? So velocity, if you see along this AB side or A dash B dash side, the velocity at different positions of the element along x axis, along the differential distance partial x, is varying. And it is having this value at this point. So So that's why it is written partial v over partial x into delta x, showing the variation of velocity with respect to x, and showing the overall variation up to this point, that is partial v over partial x into delta x. This is the velocity at this point where the movement has taken place from b to b dash multiplied by time. So this is the distance covered. So delta alpha angle will be vertical distance over horizontal distance. That will be delta alpha. Similarly, and this movement has taken place in the y direction and in the positive y direction. So upward is the positive y direction and downward is the negative y direction. So this movement of the element from b to b dash is in the positive y direction, which is shown in, the, in over here. Then coming to the other side of the element, which is AD. So if you see AD and A dash D dash, they also are having angle between them, that is delta beta. So this movement from D to D dash of the element has is in the negative x direction. It is on the negative x direction. This movement has taken place. That's why it will next you will see there will be negative sign coming with this distance, because the movement of the element has taken place on the negative x-axis. Now movement of from D to D dash, just like over here, this movement is along x-axis. Velocity along x-axis is u. So partial u over partial y into dy delta y. This is the velocity at this point, multiplied by delta t. So this is the distance covered from D to D dash, and the angle delta beta will be vertical distance. This distance covered, partial u or partial y into delta t, divided by the horizontal. This with respect to this angle, this is the horizontal. This is delta y. This is how this figure can be explained, and these parameters can be determined. So same thing explained over here. Consider a small two-dimensional fluid element A, B, C, D at any time t, and during a short interval time travel delta t, it moves from one position to another position in the process, and it deforms as indicated in figure 5.2. So deformation mean over here the change of the axis, you can say a change of the shape. So firstly, shape was like this. Now the shape is slightly changed. This is called as a deformation, or movement, or rotation, you can see. Now further, consider figure 5.3b, the second figure I already explained, in which positions of the fluid element at any time t and t plus delta t are superimposed. So both the positions are superimposed over here. Let delta x and delta y are the dimensions of the element in x and y direction respectively. Now delta alpha is the rotation of face AB, which is the angle between AB and A dash B dash, that is clear. And delta beta, this is not delta B, this is delta beta, so you can correct it later. Delta beta is the rotation of face AD, this is the angle between AD and A dash D dash. Now further, what is delta alpha? That is vertical distance over horizontal distance. So this is the slope, you can say. So this is partial v or partial x into delta t divided by delta x. So delta x will be cancelled. So remaining will be partial v or partial x into delta t. This is the rotation of face AB, delta alpha. Similarly, delta beta, minus partial u or partial y into delta t. Minus means it is on the negative x direction, y by delta y. So it gains cancelled. So delta beta is minus partial u or partial y into delta t. So this is how the rotation of face AB and rotation of face AD can be determined. Now rate of rotation, that is rotation per unit time. Rate of rotation of face AB is mega alpha. This is delta alpha or delta t. So if you put the value of delta alpha, this is partial v over partial x into delta t divided by delta t. So delta t will be cancelled, so it will be partial v over partial x. So this is the rate of rotation of face AB of the element. Then rate of rotation of the face AD of the element, that is mega beta. This is delta beta or delta t. Again, delta t will be cancelled, so it is minus partial u or partial y. This is how rate of rotation can be determined. Now, net rate of rotation about z axis of the element. So this is the rate of rotation of the face AB, and this is the rate of rotation of the face AD for the element. But net rate of rotation of the element for the entire element will be omega alpha plus omega beta divided by 2. That is the net rotation of the whole element, including both the faces. So omega alpha plus omega beta divided by 2. So putting the values, partial v over partial x minus partial u over partial y is divided by 2. So we know that if this net rotation of the element is zero, it is a irrotational flow. So condition for irrotational flow is that omega alpha plus omega beta divided by 2 are the net rate of rotation must be zero for the element. So putting zero over here, 2 will come over in constant, it will become zero. So partial u over partial x minus partial u over partial y is equal to zero. So this is the condition for irrotational flow. And if it is not zero, it means that the flow will be rotational flow. So this is how mathematically we can define irrotational flow and rotational flow by these equations. Now let us see how we can use these equations. So you are given with again the same flow fields as in example one. So you have to check the flow fields for rotational or irrotational flows. So we know that these are the two-dimensional flow fields, and using the condition for irrotational flow first, that is partial v over partial x minus partial u over partial y is equal to zero. So now let us take the first flow field. U is minus 2y, v is 3x. So we have to find partial v over partial x. So v is 3x, so partial of 3x over partial x is 3, and u is minus 2y. So partial of minus 2y over partial y is minus 2. Now putting the values in this equation, so 2, 3, partial v over partial x is 3, and partial u over partial y is minus 2. So 3 minus minus 2 is 5, and obviously 5 is not a zero value. So it means that this flow field is rotational flow field. It is not a irrotational flow field. It is a rotational flow field. Now second is u is 0, v is 3xy. Now put in the values, partial v over partial x. So v is 3xy. So partial of 3xy over partial x is 3y. And partial u is 0. So partial of 0 over partial y is 0. Put in the values again, partial v over partial x is 3y. And partial u over partial y is 0. So 3y minus 0 is obviously not 0. So again, this is also the rotational flow, because it is not equal to 0, so it is a rotational flow. Similarly, you can do it for the third case, u is 2x, v is minus 2y, partial of minus 2y over partial x is 0, and partial of 2x over partial y is 0, because there is no x term over here, there is no y term over here, so it will be treated as constants, so constant ka derivative of 0 over. So 0 minus 0 is 0, it means that the third flow field is irrotational flow field. This is how we can find the rotational or irrotational flow field using the equations. Another example, you are given with the following flow field, u is 2 and v is 8x. You have to check the continuity as well as the irrotationality of the following flow field. Don't you check me as me? So first of all, continuity, because it is a two-dimensional flow field. और इसमें जो कॉन्टिन्यूटी है टू डिमेंशन में वो पता है हमें, पार्शियल यू और पार्शियल एक्स प्लस पार्शियल वी और पार्शियल वाई इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो इसमें यू टू है और वी एट एक्स है, तो पार्शियल ऑफ टू और पार्शियल एक्स जीरो आ जाएगा, पार्शियल ऑफ एट एक्स और पार्शियल वाई भी जीरो आ जाएगा. सो जीरो प्लस जीरो इज जीरो, सो इट मीन्स दैट दिस फ्लो फील्ड इज अगेन फॉलोइंग द सेटिस्फाइंग द कॉन्टिन्यूटी, सो इट इज अ कॉन्टिन्यूस फ्लो फील्ड. नाउ लेट अस चेक द सेम फ्लो फील्ड फॉर इरोटेशनैलिटी. We know that for irrotational flow, partial u over partial x minus partial u over partial y is 0. So we know that v is 8x. So partial of 8x over partial x is 8. And partial of, and u is 2. So partial of 2 over partial y is 0. So 8 minus 0 is 8. It means that this flow field is rotational flow field. So this is how we can check both continuity and rotationality or irrotationality of the flow field given the equation and the data. Next is circulation and vorticity. Now let us consider streamlines shown in figure 5.4 represent a two-dimensional flow field, while I'll represent any closed path in this field. So if you see the diagram,
the lines with arrows. These are called the flow lines or the stream lines. You will learn in this lecture more about them. So these represent the average direction of flow of the fluid. Stream lines, they represent the average direction of the flow of the field. So it means the flow is taking place in this direction, and there is a differential element of the fluid which is moving in closed path. तो फ्लूड इस तरफ मूव कर रहा है और फ्लूड के अंदर जो उसका डिफरेंशियल एक एलिमेंट है या एक से ज्यादा एलिमेंट्स हैं, यहाँ एक एलिमेंट से शुरू हुआ, तो डिफरेंशियल एलिमेंट ऑफ द फ्लूड इज मूविंग अलोंग अ क्लोज पाथ विद इन द फ्लो. नाउ टेंजेंट टू द स्ट्रीम लाइन, रिमेंबर दिस, एट एनी पॉइंट आर एट द पॉइंट एट द लेवल ऑफ द आर एट द पॉइंट ऑफ द डिफरेंशियल एलिमेंट, द टेंजेंट टू द स्ट्रीम लाइन इज द वेलोसिटी वेक्टर. रिमेंबर दिस, इफ यू टेक टेंजेंट टू द स्ट्रीम लाइन एट एनी पॉइंट, इट विल बी द वेलोसिटी वेक्टर एट दैट पॉइंट. सेकेंडली, इफ यू टेक द टेंजेंट टू द क्लोज पाथ, सो द एंगल बिटवीन द टेंजेंट टू द क्लोज पाथ एंड टेंजेंट एंड द वेलोसिटी वेक्टर इन द पॉजिटिव direction of flow, this is the direction of flow, mean clockwise in this case you can say approximately. So this is the angle beta, angle between tangent to the flow path and the velocity vector in the positive flow direction is the beta angle. So along this tangent to the flow path, velocity has component v cos beta. So actually v cos beta is the velocity component along the closed path with which this differential element of the fluid is moving, and the length of this closed path is L. Now when this differential element comes over here, for example, so at this point velocity vector will be again tangent to the flow line, stream line, and angle between tangent to the path and tangent to the this circular path or closed path, and velocity vector is beta. But this angle beta is between is toward the positive direction of flow. So yahan clockwise mein aayega, counter nahi aayega. Isi tarah when the differential element comes to this point, so again to the tangent to the streamline is velocity vector, and tangent to the closed path, the angle between them is beta again in the positive y direction, the positive direction of flow. तो इस तरह इसको हम डिफाइन करते हैं. दिस इज सर्कुलेशन अराउंड अ क्लोज पाथ इन टू डायमेंशनल फ्लो फील्ड, द टू डायमेंशनल फ्लो फील्ड इन विच सर्कुलेशन इज बीइंग स्टडीड. सो लेट द स्ट्रीम लाइन शोन इन फिगर 5.4 रिप्रेजेंट अ टू डायमेंशनल फ्लो फील्ड एज आई एक्सप्लेन्ड, व्हाइल एल रिप्रेजेंट एनी क्लोज पाथ इन दिस फील्ड. नाउ व्हाट इज सर्कुलेशन बाय मैथमेटिकली हाउ इट इज डिफाइंड, सर्कुलेशन इट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय द लेटर गैमा. So circulation gamma is defined mathematically as the line integral of the velocity about a closed path. So line integral of the velocity about a closed path is known as circulation. So this symbol shows the line integral for the length L of the closed path, and V is a velocity vector into dl. So line integral of the velocity about a closed path is known as the circulation. And further, in terms of its component, v in the sign of integration from closed path into v cos of beta into dl, this is mathematically circulation, where v is the velocity in the flow field at the element dl of the path, and beta is is angle between velocity and tangent to the path at that point in positive direction along the path. So this is about the beta. Further, since this is the overall circulation, but over here we are taking a differential element of the fluid. So for differential element of the fluid, the resulting circulation will also be differential. So differential circulation is given by this equation. Iski derivation bhi hai, that is not part of this. To aapne yehi yaad rakhna hai. So differential circulation is partial v over partial x minus partial u over partial y is dx into dy. Dx dy are the dimensions of the two dimensional area or two dimensional enclosed area. So this is the differential circulation, partial u over partial x minus partial u over partial y is into dx into dy. Now what is vorticity? vorticity, which is indicated by the letter xi, xi, xi or psi Bhaskar bolte hain isko. So the vorticity xi is defined as the psi is defined as the circulation per unit enclosed area. So circulation, this one, divided by the area enclosed, that is called as vorticity. So vorticity is circulation is basically a phenomena, and vorticity is that phenomena per unit area, per unit enclosed area. So if you divide this partial v over partial x minus partial u over partial y into dx into dy, divided by dx into dy, so you will come to this, that vorticity is equal to partial v over partial x minus partial u over partial y. So ye vorticity aa jayegi. So the same equation is for rotational and irrotational flow. So remember this, for irrotational flow vorticity will be zero. For irrotational flow, चूंकि ये partial v और partial x minus partial v और partial y zero आ जाता है irrotational flow के लिए, तो for vorticity, for irrotational flow vorticity is zero and it will have certain value for rotational flow. So vorticity is only defined for the, or it will have certain value for the rotational flow. It will be zero for the irrotational flow. Now let us check the irrotationality of the following flow field and also calculate the vorticity. We are given with the following flow field, u is 25y and v is equal to 0. So partial v over partial x minus partial u over partial y is equal to 0. This is the condition for irrotational flow. Now putting the value of v, that is 0. So partial of 0 over partial x is 0. And putting the value of u, partial u over partial y. So partial of 25y over partial y is 25. Putting the values in this, so 0 minus 25 is minus 25, which is not 0, so obviously it is a rotational flow. It is a rotational flow. And what is the value of vorticity? That is minus 25. So this is how we can check the vorticity, and we can also check the irrotationality or rotationality of the flow field. So any question up till now, if you have, you can ask before I move to the next can say part of this topic, that is lecture number 2. So this is the end of lecture number 1. Any question anybody having, so please ask. So ye slides bhi share ho chuki hain, aur dusri slide maine jo aaj humne shuru karna hai, discuss karna hai, wo maine already bhej di hui thi, wo bhi aap download kare aur later is recording se aap usko dekh sakte hain. Yes, any question anybody having, please ask. From today's discussion. So up till now, today we have discussed how mathematically we can define the rotational and irrotational flow, and further we can, how we can check it for the flow field. And secondly, we have learned about the circulation and vorticity considering certain two-dimensional flow field. Now let us start with the chapter number, this lecture number 2 for the second week, and try to complete this topic if you don't have any question. The next thing to discuss is what are streamlines, or we call them as psi lines, are flow lines. Streamlines, psi lines are flow lines. It is an imaginary line representing the mean direction of velocities of a number of fluid particles in motion. So these are the imaginary lines. When you see the fluid flowing, you don't see these lines in that case. So these are the imaginary lines that we make ourselves just to represent the average direction or mean direction of the velocities of a number of fluid particles, or in other words, mean direction of the fluid flow. Tangent drawn at any point on the flow line gives the velocity vector. That's that thing you should remember, that if you draw a tangent to flow line at any point, that is the velocity vector at that point. These lines represent the pattern of flow and are helpful in determining the rate of flow. So they are used to find the rate of flow in different scenarios. These are the lines for which stream function psi is constant. So stream function psi is constant along the streamline or the flow line. Properties of streamlines, kya kya hai? Number one, there can be no flow across a streamline. So these are the streamlines shown with arrow. So along the streamline, this psi function or the stream function will be constant. Means the differential of stream function will be zero along the line. D psi will be zero. And there can be no flow across these lines. तो ऐसा नहीं हो सकता कि ये लाइन ऐसे हैं और फ्लो जो है इनके क्रॉस में हो रहा है. तो फ्लो हमेशा इन्हीं लाइन के अलॉन्ग होगा जो मैक्सिमम या एवरेज डायरेक्शन ऑफ फ्लो है. सो देयर कैन बी नो फ्लो अक्रॉस दी स्ट्रीम लाइंस. स्ट्रीम लाइन स्पेसिंग वेरीज इनवर्सली विद रिस्पेक्ट टू वेलोसिटी, दैट इज मोर वेलोसिटी लेस स्पेसिंग एंड वाइस वर्सा. तो ऐसी जगह जहां वेलोसिटी बढ़ रही है तो स्ट्रीम लाइन की स्पेसिंग जो है वो कम हो जाएगी, और जहां वेलोसिटी कम हो रही है स्ट्रीम लाइन की स्पेसिंग जो है बढ़ जाएगी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ द फ्लो इज टेकिंग प्लेस इन अ कन्वर्जिंग पाइप तो स्ट्रीम लाइन स्पेसिंग विल बी रिड्यूस्ड, एंड इफ द फ्लो इज टेकिंग प्लेस इन अ डाइवर्जिंग पाइप द स्ट्रीम लाइन स्पेसिंग विल बी इंक्रीज्ड. Now consider any point P on a particular stream line. This is the point with coordinates x and y. So consider the point P on streamline having coordinate x and y. This is the point P. Let v is the velocity vector at this point having two components u and v, and theta is the angle of velocity vector with the x-axis. So let this v is the velocity vector which is tangent to the streamline at this point P, and it has two components. One is along y-axis v, and one is along x-axis, that is u, and the angle between v and x-axis is theta. Now we know that tangent theta is v over u, this vertical component divided by the horizontal component, and also we know that tangent theta is vertical distance divided by horizontal distance. Vertical distance, differential vertical distance is dy, and horizontal differential distance is dx. So comparing this tangent theta v over u and tangent theta dy over dx, so we know that we write v over u is equal to dy over dx. So v over u is equal to dy over dx from this. Further, you can write v into dx minus u into dy. You can multiply across, and then we can write u into dy minus v into dx is equal to zero. This is the equation of the streamline. Typical equation of streamline is given. Our equation of streamline is given. That is u dy minus v dx is equal to zero. It means that along a streamline, the variation will be along x and y axis of u and v. This is the equation of streamline. Then we have the equipotential line or phi line, we call it. We have the streamline which is called psi line, and we have the phi line or equipotential line. Now these are the imaginary lines which represent the points of equal pressure head in a flow. So these are the imaginary lines again, and they represent the points of equal pressure head in a flow. Velocity potential function is constant along these lines. So along a phi line, the velocity potential function phi will be constant. That is, d phi will be zero along this line. Now the stream function next. What is stream function and what is velocity potential function? So stream function, which is represented by psi in Cartesian coordinate system, two-dimensional coordinate system xy, is mathematically defined for a Cartesian coordinate system as, so you should remember this equation, very important one. So partial psi or partial y is u. So velocity along x-axis is given by, in terms of function psi, stream function is partial psi or partial y. And then for v, it is minus partial psi or partial x. So this is how we can mathematically define a stream function in Cartesian coordinate system, two-dimensional or x-y coordinate system. U is partial psi or partial y, and v is minus partial psi or partial x. Similarly, velocity potential function are phi function. So the velocity potential function, which is represented with the letter phi, is mathematically defined for a Cartesian coordinate system as u is partial phi over partial x and v is partial phi over partial y. So partial phi over partial x is u, velocity along x-axis, and partial phi over partial y is v, velocity along y-axis. This is how mathematically we can define the velocity potential function. Now, next thing is orthogonality of phi lines and psi lines. Orthogonality means orthogonal, we know it. Mean one line is perpendicular to a normal to the other line. In other words, you can say. So we have to prove over here that the phi line and psi lines, they cross each other at normal angles or at perpendicular angles or at 90 degree angles, you can say. Or both the lines are orthogonal to each other. So that is the thing that we have to prove over here. So first of all, and for this, we need to find the slope of the line. If the slope of the line is reversed to each other, so we will say that both are orthogonal to each other, both are at normal angle to each other. Now mathematically, now first of all, considering a line along which psi is constant. So what is that line along which psi is constant? That is a streamline. So streamline is the one along which this stream function psi is constant. Mathematically, along the streamline, d psi is 0. There is no change in psi with respect to x and y. So d psi is 0. And we know that, what is d psi? Differential of psi is partial psi or partial x into dx plus partial psi or partial y into dy. This is the expression for d psi. The differential of psi in two-dimensional plane will be varying with the dx and also with respect to y, x and y. Now we know that for a streamline, this d psi is 0. And also we know that mathematically u is partial psi over partial y and v is minus partial psi over partial x. Minus v is partial psi over partial x. In both ways you can write. So putting the values, instead of partial psi or partial y, you can put u, and instead of partial psi or partial x, you can put minus v. So minus v dx plus u dy is d psi. So d psi is 0, you know, for the streamline. So minus d v dx plus u dy is 0, or you can write, you can take this term on the other side. So dy over dx will be v over u. So dusra le jaye aur dx ko iske niche le aaye, so dy over dx will be equal to v over u. So this is the slope of the streamline. Slope of the streamline is dy over dx, that is u v over u. Now let us see what is the slope of the phi line. This is the slope of the psi line. Ye slope jo hai psi line ki hai. Now let us see what is the slope of the phi line. So let us consider a line along which phi is constant. That is the phi line or the equipotential line. So we know that mathematically d phi is 0 along the phi line. And we also know d phi is partial phi over partial x into dx plus partial phi over partial y into dy. Where we also know that mathematically the equipotential function is u is partial phi over partial x and v is partial phi over partial y. So putting the values, so u dx plus v dy is equal to d phi, so d phi is 0. So u dx plus v dy, in this way we can right equal to 0. Further, you can again find, you can take this term on the other side. So dy over dx will be u over v with negative sign. So what does it show? The slope of the streamline is v over u, and the slope of the phi line is u over v. So it means that from equation 1 and 2, it is obvious that phi lines and psi lines will always intersect normally. So ye dono ek dusre pe normally intersect karengi. That is called orthogonality of phi lines and psi lines. This is how we can prove that phi lines and psi lines are orthogonal to each other. They cross each other normally because their slopes are opposite to each other. Slope of the streamline is u over v, v over u, and slope of the phi line is u over v. This is also shown over here. This is the streamline. These are the streamlines psi k1, k2, k3. These are the streamlines. And when you have to make the phi line, so they should be at the point of crossing, you see, they should be normal to each other. So jahan jahan phi line aur psi line cross karegi, to ye angle dono ke darmiyan 90 degree hona chahiye. So that is called as the orthogonality of phi line and the psi lines. So we can see these are psi lines and these are phi lines which are crossing each other normally. Again, tangent to the psi line, streamline is velocity vector, and it has two components, u and v. By definition, for the equipotential line, this u and v have been defined. This is a flow net. Isko hum discuss karenge end pe. Okay, what is a flow net? This is actually the combination of phi line and the psi lines. Next thing that we have to see, existence of stream function and velocity potential function. That is, in which case, actually we have two possibilities over here that we will discuss. One is the continuous flow, and other is the rotational or irrotational flow. So we have to see that when there is a continuous flow, so which of the function will definitely exist. So humne ye dekhna hai ki jab continuous flow hoga to stream function aur velocity potential function mein se kaun sa jo hai zarur exist karega, zarur lazmi hoga. Isi tarah when the flow is rotational or irrotational, which type of the function will be definitely existing. So number one, for continuity of flow in two dimensional form, we know that partial u over partial x plus partial v over partial y is equal to 0. This is what we know, two dimensional continuity equation. Now if you consider stream function first, hum dekhte hain ki continuity equation ko kaun satisfy karta hai, ya continuity continuity of flow ke form jab continuity of flow hogi us waqt kaun sa function exist karega zaruri lazmi. So first of all, let us check for the stream function psi. We know that mathematically partial psi over partial y is u, and partial psi over partial x is minus v. So if you put the values over here, instead of u, you can put partial psi over partial y like in this. And instead of v, you can put minus partial psi over partial x, like put over here in equation number one, the continuity equation. So partial of partial psi over partial y over partial x, and partial of minus partial psi over partial x over partial y is 0. This is the after putting the values. Now further, if you multiply, so partial square psi over partial x partial y, that will come, and with this in the negative sign, making the positive in the negative sign. So partial square psi over partial x partial y is equal to 0. So it means that when there will be continuous flow, and in case of stream function, the continuity equation is satisfied, always satisfied. So it means that, and if you see, the left hand side and the right hand side of the equation are same. So left hand side of the equation 1 will always be 0. So jab bhi stream function ko hum le put karenge, to continuity equation kya hai, satisfy ho jayegi. Iska kya matlab hai ki stream function will always exist in continuous flow. This is the bottom line, and this is the final outcome, that stream function will always exist in continuous flow. For example, आपको कोई flow field दिया जाता है और आपको आ जाता है check करें भी कि इसमें जो stream function है वो exist करेगा या नहीं करेगा. So what you have to do, you just have to check the continuity of that equation, that flow. If the flow is continuous, you can safely write that yes, stream function will exist. So this is how its application can be made. Now let us check the other one, considering whether the velocity potential function will exist in continuous flow or not, that we have to check. Now considering the velocity potential function phi, we know that mathematically partial phi over partial x is u, and partial phi over partial y is equal to v. So now putting the values in continuity equation, instead of u you can put partial phi over partial x, and instead of v you can put partial phi over partial y. Again multiplying inside, so partial square phi over partial x square plus partial square phi over partial y square. So that is equal to zero. So the left hand side of the equation number 2 may or may not be zero. This is called as the Laplace equation for velocity potential function. Question number 2 is the Laplace equation for velocity potential function. The left hand side of the equation may or may not be zero. जरूरी नहीं है कि हर तरह zero, जरूर definite नहीं है कि zero है ये. Zero हो भी सकती है, zero नहीं भी हो सकती. So left hand side of this equation number 2 may or may not be zero. So velocity potential function may or may not exist in continuous flow. This is the outcome, that the velocity potential function may or may not exist in continuous flow. तो हमने एक चीज चेक कर ली, कॉन्टिन्यूस फ्लो के अंदर स्ट्रीम फंक्शन तो लाजमी एग्जिस्ट करेगा और वेलोसिटी पोटेंशियल फंक्शन जरूरी नहीं है कि एग्जिस्ट करे, कर भी सकता है और नहीं भी कर सकता. नाउ लेट अस चेक इट फॉर द बोथ द स्ट्रीम फंक्शन एंड द वेलोसिटी पोटेंशियल फंक्शन देयर एग्जिस्टेंस फॉर द इररोटेशनल फ्लो. नाउ फॉर द इररोटेशनलिटी ऑफ फ्लो और फॉर द इररोटेशनल फ्लो वी नो दैट the equation is partial v over partial x minus partial u over partial y is equal to 0. This is the equation, and we have to see that when the flow is irrotational, which of the functions will definitely exist. So humne ye dekhna hai, jaise humne piche check kiya continuity ke liye, let us check it for the irrotationality of flow. So this is the equation for irrotational flow. Now first of all, considering the stream function psi, we know that partial psi over partial x is u, and partial psi over partial y is u, and partial psi over partial x is minus v. This is mathematically we can define the stream function. Now putting the values of v and u in this equation of irrotational flow, so instead of v it is minus partial psi over partial x, and instead of v it is instead of u it is partial psi over partial y. Now again it will be so if you take negative out and take minus one outside and take it on the other side, so it will become plus. So it will be partial square psi over partial x square plus partial square psi over partial y square is equal to zero. So again, if you see the left hand side of the equation may or may not be zero. The left hand side of equation number 3 may or may not be zero. So stream function may or may not exist in irrotational flow. So in case of irrotational flow, stream function may or may not exist. So exist kar bhi sakta hai aur exist nahi bhi kar sakta. Now on the same lines, you can check it for the velocity potential function. Now for velocity potential function phi, we know that mathematically partial phi over partial x is equal to u, and partial phi over partial y is equal to v. So putting the values in this equation for rotational flow, instead of v we can put partial phi over partial y, this one, and instead of u we can put partial phi over partial x. So if you multiply, so this will be partial square phi over partial xy, partial x partial y, minus partial square phi over partial x partial y is equal to 0.
it is definite that the left hand side of the equation number 4 will always be zero. It means that velocity potential function will always exist in irrotational flow. So velocity potential function will always exist in irrotational flow. That is what we have found. So up till now in this lecture, we have learned what is streamline and what is equipotential line. And then what is stream function and what is equipotential function, velocity potential function. And we have learned that both these functions, both the streamline and the equipotential, they cross each other at normal, mean both are orthogonal to each other. And we have learned that in case of continuous flow, stream function will definitely exist. And in case of irrotational flow, velocity potential function will definitely exist. So now, up till now, any question before we go for the numericals? If we have a question, ask. Yes, sir. सबको समझ आ गई है? क्वेश्चन है किसी का? चले मैं पूछ लेता हूँ उससे. रोल नंबर 60, आर यू प्रेजेंट? यस, रोल नंबर 60 प्रेजेंट है?
यस सर.
चलिए ये बताएं कि स्ट्रीम फंक्शन, स्ट्रीम लाइन और इक्विपोटेंशियल लाइन जो है वो एक दूसरे को नॉर्मल क्रॉस करती है, इसकी क्या रीजन है, या इसका कैसे प्रूफ हम करेंगे, या इसका क्या आंसर है? क्यों भाई, अभी तो बताया. No idea. क्यों भाई? जी रोल नंबर 61 आप बताएं भाई.
Yes sir.
जी बोलें. Yes, anybody else? Chalein, roll number 70, are present hai?
Yes, sir.
Aap bataye bhai. Dono jo lines hain wo normal hai ek dusre ki, iski kya justification hai ya kaise aap iska answer karenge?
Parallel hai to.
No
sir, no idea.
पांच मिनट पहले मैंने बताया, एक दो मिनट पहले बताया, वो चीज आपको नहीं पता है. तो आप लोग सोए हुए हैं. चले सी आर तुम बताओ भी. यस सी आर, एनी आइडिया? क्यों भी हो आप मीटिंग में सीआर, यस नो का जवाब दो ना यार, हो या नहीं हो.
सर मीटिंग में हूँ, लेकिन सर वो नेट का मसला, तो आवाज क्लियर नहीं आती रही, तो मुझे इतना सही आइडिया नहीं अभी.
चले कोई और आंसर देना चाहे, किसी को समझ आई हो आवाज जिससे क्लियर पहुंच गई हो. यस, तो हमारे पास एक ही इसके प्रूफ है कि दोनों लाइनों की जो स्लोप है वो एक दूसरे का उलट है. जाहिर है जब ऐसा हो तो दोनों लाइनों का जो एक दूसरे के साथ क्रॉस है वो नॉर्मल होगा. ठीक है, इसका ये सिंपल आंसर है. आई डोंट नो कि वो क्या मसला है, क्यों आपको समझ नहीं आ रही. तो इतनी एफर्ट या एग्जर्ट करने का क्या फ़ायदा जब आप लोग को सुन ही नहीं रहे, आपको समझ नहीं आ रही. एनी हाउ, चलें ये बताएं कोई स्टूडेंट, बजाय मैं पॉइंट आउट करूँ अब, कि कॉन्टिन्यूस फ्लो में कौन सा फंक्शन एग्जिस्ट करेगा लाजमी और उसकी क्या रीज़न है, या उसका क्या प्रूफ है? यस, जब कॉन्टिन्यूस फ्लो होगा तो स्ट्रीम फंक्शन या वेलोसिटी पोटेंशियल फंक्शन में से कौन सा एग्जिस्ट करेगा और उसको कैसे हम प्रूव कर सकते हैं? यस, तो चूंकि स्ट्रीम फंक्शन जो है वो कॉन्टिन्यूटी को सेटिस्फाई करेगा हमेशा, इसलिए कॉन्टिन्यूटी इक्वेशन में स्ट्रीम फंक्शन जो है एग्जिस्ट करेगा और वेलोसिटी पोटेंशियल फंक्शन एग्जिस्ट कर भी सकता है और नहीं भी कर। ऐसा नहीं हम कह सकते कि वेलोसिटी पोटेंशियल फंक्शन एग्जिस्ट नहीं करेगा, ये नहीं कहा मैंने, कर सकता है या नहीं कर सकता, दोनों ऑप्शन इसमें आ सकती हैं, पॉसिबिलिटी आ सकती है। चले भी इसको आपने दोबारा से पढ़ना है जिन लोगों को अभी समझ नहीं आई, या बाद में उसको देखें ताकि चीजें आपको समझ आए। तो लेट मी कंटिन्यू विद द लेक्चर और इसको कंप्लीट करता हूँ मैं, फिर दोबारा से आता हूँ क्वेश्चन की तरफ। सो लेट अस यूज दिस डिस्कशंस टू सॉल्व सम न्यूमेरिकल्स।
सर ये आप, एक्सक्यूज मी सर, सर आपने जो स्लाइड्स भेजी थी लेक्चर टू की, उसमें हमें ये स्लाइड्स नहीं मिली थी, वो कोई और स्लाइड्स आपने भेज दी थी, उसका लिंक दे दिया सर आप काइंडली। ये स्लाइड्स
कौन सी स्लाइड्स है वो?
वो आई थिंक सो ब्लू कलर में कोई फ्लूइड से फर्स्ट स्लाइड्स के ही थोड़ी बहुत 5-6 स्लाइड्स हैं, पहली फर्स्ट जो आपने स्लाइड्स भेजी थी ना उसकी कोई 5-7 स्लाइड्स का पीडीएफ है।
अच्छा चले मैं चेक करता हूं वैसे अभी के कौन सी स्लाइड्स हैं वो सेक्शन, क्यों भी ऐसा ही है कोई और भी अगर बताए मुझे सेक्शन भी। Let me check.
Yes, sir, उसमें सिर्फ इंट्रो था।
एक मिनट मैं चेक कर रहा हूँ इसको कि कहाँ पे मिस्टेक हुई है। Let's continue. So in example number 5, you are given with certain flow fields, which are in terms of the stream function, determine the velocity potential function for the following. So, आपको stream function दिया गया, उसने कहा जी इसमें से velocity potential function निकालें इसकी base पे। So, first is size 30y represents uniform flow with a velocity 30 meter per second parallel to x-axis in positive x direction. So, what is given to you? Size 30y. So we know that size 30y, and we also know that by mathematically u is equal to partial psi over partial y. So putting the value of psi over here, it means wait kare, I will come back to you. So you are given with the psi function. Remember this, when the psi or phi function are given to you, inki koi expression diye gaye honge, jo bhi value di gayi ho, so from there the first step mostly is to find velocities u and v. So kyunki hame pata hai ki psi aur phi jo hain dono velocity se related hain, to isse hum velocities find kar sakte hain aur uske baad uska fir expression bana sakte hain. So psi is 30y given to you, and we know that partial psi or partial y is u. So partial psi or partial y is u. So putting the value of psi over here, so partial of 30y or partial y is 30. And v is, we know that v is minus partial psi or partial x. So ye cheeze aapko yaad karni padengi ki psi function se related v or u kaise nikalte hain ya kaise related hai, aur phi function se v or u kaise related hai. So v is minus partial psi or partial x. So when you put partial of 30y or partial x will be 0. तो यहाँ इसलिए 0 लिखा गया। और ऐसे भी इसमें बताया कि इसमें y के लोग जो है वो कंपोनेंट नहीं है, ये x के लोग हैं, तो इसको भी आप ऐसे भी इस तरह भी 0 लिख सकते हैं। So we know that d phi, differential of phi is u dx plus v dy, And now putting the values of u and v in this equation, so d phi will be u dx, v 0 is mein, and d phi will be 30 dx. Now taking the integration to find phi, so it will be indefinite integral, so that's why integration of 30 into dx will be 30x plus the symbol of integration. This is how you can find the phi function given the psi function. You will be samajh aayi isko, you samajh na aayi ho iski? Anybody? Clear hai sabko ki kaise nikalna hai phi function? So firstly we'll find the velocities and then we write the phi function differential form, and then from there taking the integration you can write the equation for the velocity potential function. Similarly you can do it for the psi function as well. Now for the part B, psi is minus 40x, so we know that, and if you read psi is minus 40x, represent the uniform flow with a velocity 40 meter per second parallel to y axis in positive y direction. It means that u is 0 in this case. So और वैसे भी वो जीरो ही आएगा अगर हम उसकी एक्सप्रेशन को लिखेंगे. सो साई इज माइनस 40x, सो v इज माइनस साई और पार्शियल साई और पार्शियल x, वी नो इट पुटिंग द वैल्यूज. सो माइनस इज पार्शियल ऑफ माइनस 40x और पार्शियल x इज 40, माइनस 40 इनटू माइनस दैट विल बी 40. u इज इक्वल टू 0 इन दिस केस, u इज पार्शियल साई और पार्शियल y. सो पार्शियल चूंकि इसमें 40x अगर पुट करेंगे, पार्शियल ऑफ माइनस 40x और पार्शियल y विल बी 0. नाउ अगेन राइटिंग द इक्वेशन फॉर दिस फंक्शन phi, डिफरेंशियल ऑफ phi इज u dx plus v dy, पुटिंग द वैल्यू d phi इज v dy, u 0 है इसमें, 40 dy, टेकिंग इंटीग्रेशन सो इट विल बी 40y plus c एज द इक्वेशन फॉर द वेलोसिटी पोटेंशियल फंक्शन. इन द थर्ड पार्ट you are given with size 17.3y minus 10x. So, ye angle 30 degree pe x axis se. So, if size 17.3y minus 10x, so u is partial psi or partial x. So, iska partial le le y ke saath. So, it will be 17.3 minus 10x ka 0 a jayega. So, 17.3 is u. Phir v nikaal le, minus partial psi or partial x. So, putting the value in this psi, so partial of 17.3y minus 10x over partial x, so ye wala term 0 aa jayegi aur ye minus x 10 into minus, so ye 1, ye 10 aa jayega. Putting the values in that equation, u dx plus v dy is d phi, so 17 into dx plus 10 dy, taking integration, so 17x plus 10y plus c is the answer for it. So this is how, given the psi function, we can find the equation for the phi function. You should try it at your places also with various values of psi, and even you can try for the phi. For example, agar aapko yahi phi diya hota, aapne ye karna hai. If this is the phi, so find the stream function. Isi ko aapne repeat karna hai. You have to repeat it, taking this as phi, velocity potential function, and find the expression for psi. Further, a flow field is characterized by this stream function. Determine the vorticity. So, आपको ये flow field दिया गया है, जो कि stream functions के related base पे है, और आपने vorticity find करनी है. So, you are given that psi is 12.5 y square. So, u is partial psi or partial y. We know it. That is partial of 12 y square by partial y, so it will be derivative of 12.5 y square over dy. So we are taking 12.5 into 2 into y, so 25 y is the answer for it. I hope you know the derivation. Derivation of partial y square over partial y kya hoti hai? That is 2 times y. So 2 times y into 12.5, 25 y. We know that v is minus partial over partial x, and putting the value over here, 12.5 y square, that will be 0. Vorticity we know is partial v over partial x minus partial u over partial y, that is 0. That ye iski value is tarah aayegi.
putting the value partial v or partial x 0 and partial u or partial y is isko agar put kar de u ki jagah to it will be partial of 25y or partial y that is 25 so 0 minus 25 is minus 25 so in this way we can find the vorticity given the flow field in terms of the in terms of stream function in the same lines we can define two dimensional flow field is characterized as we can find again vorticity so there is another flow field given to you defined by the stream function again the same procedure find u putting the value partial psi or partial y so this 3xy minus 3xk minus 3yk you can find v minus partial psi or partial x so it is minus 6xy so vorticity is partial v or partial x minus partial u or partial y putting the values for v over here and for u and taking the partial so it is minus 6y plus 6y so vorticity becomes zero it means it is a irrotational flow तो ये फ्लो फील्ड जो है इरोटेशनल फ्लो फील्ड है इसकी जो वोर्टिसिटी है वो जीरो आ गई दिस इज हाउ वी कैन डू यू कैन फाइंड दिस इन प्रॉब्लम नंबर 8 अगेन यू आर गिवन विद द फ्लो फील्ड u3x v - 3y यू हैव टू चेक द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ साई एंड फाई एंड डिटरमाइन देयर एक्सप्रेशन सो स्ट्रीम फंक्शन विल एग्जिस्ट इन इफ कंटिन्यूटी इज सैटिस्फाइड इसके स्पेलिंग है वो सही कर लीजिएगा कॉन्टिन्यूटी सेटिस्फाइड होगी दो स्ट्रीम फंक्शन एग्जिस्ट करेगा वी नो कॉन्टिन्यूटी इक्वेशन पार्शियल यू और पार्शियल एक्स प्लस पार्शियल यू और पार्शियल वाई मस्ट बी जीरो यू दिया गया है बी दिया गया है तो थ्री माइनस थ्री इज जीरो सो इट मीन्स दिस फ्लो फील्ड इज कॉन्टिन्यूस इट मीन्स स्ट्रीम फंक्शन विल डेफिनेटली एग्जिस्ट देन यू कैन फाइंड द इक्वेशन फॉर स्ट्रीम फंक्शन वी नो डी साई इज माइनस वी डी एक्स प्लस यू डी वाई So d psi is minus putting the value of v. It is इसमें आपको v दिया गया minus 3y. So minus or minus 3y dx plus 3x is u 3x into dy. Taking integration, so this will be 3xy. This will also be 3xy plus c1. So 6xy plus c1 is the equation for psi. Now, secondly, we have to check whether the phi function will exist or not. So, phi function will exist if there is irrotational flow. So, we can check the flow field for irrotational flow. Again, putting the value v and u, and it is also satisfying the irrotationality. It means that the phi function will also exist in this flow field. So, phi function equation bhi nikal sakte hain. D phi is u dx plus v dy. इसमें वैल्यूज पुट कर दें तो आपके पास ये इक्वेशन इसकी आ जाएगी सो दिस इज हाउ वी कैन फाइंड द साई एंड फाई फंक्शन नेक्स्ट इज द फ्लो नेट्स सो फ्लो नेट इज द ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ नेटवर्क ऑफ स्ट्रीम लाइन एंड इक्विपोटेंशियल लाइन Characteristics of flow net क्या क्या है? The phi lines intersect psi lines, including the fixed boundaries normally. The unit figure of the resulting grid is approximately square. तो इन दोनों का जो मिलके बनेगा एक जो figure बनेगी वो एक square बनेगी. In the region of uniform flow, the spheres are of equal size and they increase in size in diverging flow जब velocity बढ़ रही होती है and decrease in size when there is converging flow then the velocity is increasing. तो ये The spacing of phi and psi line are equal and inversely proportional to the velocity at any point. The size of the square decreases towards the inner side of the curve, जहाँ velocity जो है वो ज़्यादा हो रही है. This is a typical flow net shown for the pi flow in bend. So you can see when there is a constant diameter pi, the spacing is constant between phi line and the psi lines. And when it is converging, या जहाँ bend आ रहा है तो वेलोसिटी बढ़ रही है तो ये जो स्क्वायर का साइज है ये कम हो रहा है द स्ट्रीम लाइंस आर कमिंग क्लोजर टू ईच अदर एंड व्हेन द कांस्टेंट डायमीटर इज देयर अगेन द स्क्वायर साइज इज सेम इस तरह डाइवर्जिंग में हो तो भी सेम होगा वो भी चेंज हो जाएगा सम एग्जांपल्स ऑफ द फ्लो नेट एंड देयर एप्लीकेशन ये आपने कहीं और भी जियोटेक में पढ़े होंगे होपफुली उसकी जो सीपेज वगैरह निकालने के लिए यूज होते हैं So we can draw the flow net under the dam. You can see it. These are the stream lines, and these are the phi lines, equipotential lines, showing the same pressure head. So you can see they are crossing normally to each other, and the square accordingly, when there is a convergence or divergence, increasing or decreasing. For the flow net through the earthen dam, to find the seepage through the dam body, earthen dam body, we can draw the flow net. So these are the stream lines, and these are the equipotential lines. Again, they are crossing normally to each other. Similarly, you can draw the flow net for the pipe flow, for the converging, diverging pipe flow, etc., for the bend of pipe. So, multiple scenarios mein aap flow net ko bana sakte hain. Next are the basic flow field. Now, flow field is a way of looking at motion of a fluid with respect to space and time. So, flow field is a way of looking at motion of a fluid with respect to space and time, or is the way to define the velocity of flow with respect to space and time. Rectilinear flow, there are two basic flow fields, rectilinear flow field and the source and sink. Rectilinear flow field, it is the simplest of flow field in which stream lines are straight, parallel and evenly spaced. So, this is the simple flow field. जिसमें जो स्ट्रीम लाइंस हैं वो इक्वली स्पेस्ड होती हैं, पैरेलल होती हैं और स्ट्रेट होती हैं. दिस इज अ रेक्टिलिनियर फ्लो फील्ड. द स्ट्रीम लाइंस आर स्ट्रेट एंड दे आर पैरेलल एंड दे आर इक्वली स्पेस्ड टू ईच अदर. देन वी हैव सोर्सेज एंड सिंक. What is source? Source is a flow field in which stream lines are symmetrically spaced and flow is radially outward from a point. Isi tarah sink is a flow field in which stream lines are symmetrically spaced and flow is radially inward from inward to a point. This is the source. Flow is radially outward from a point, and sink is when the flow is radially inward toward a point. So these are the basic flow fields. Now in this chapter you have to submit the following assignment. Ab iski submission jo hai wo 2 weeks time mein aapne karni hai, and you will submit it online. You will make up, you will do it manually or whatever preferably, and you can then make a PDF writing your roll number, and you I will tell you how to submit it in your WhatsApp. You have to submit it. I will let you know later in 2 weeks time. So you have to do the solved examples 5.1, 5.2, 5.5 from Dougherty book, and you have to do the following problems 5.4, 5.5, 5.6, 7, 8 from the Dougherty book chapter number 5. So this is about first topic, that is elementary hydrodynamics. Now I will move to the questions from your side. If anybody having any question from this topic, you can ask. Yes, any questions? तो इसको आपने go through करना है, इन slides को पिछली slide को. अभी मैं आपको थोड़ी देर तक ये जो slides हैं ये भेज देता हूँ, और उसको आपने फिर पढ़ना है, और further उसकी जो भी questions होंगे वो आप next lecture में भी पूछ सकते हैं. Yes, any questions? Okay, anyhow, if you don't have any question, I will end the meeting over here. I will stop the recording. So let me stop the recording first. So let me take the attendance. I don't know kitne log register hue hain. Last time maine kaha bhi tha ki aapne LMS pe registration apni complete karni hai, taki main direct us pe laga sakun attendance. So let me check it. Fifty-seven.
यार ये ना थोड़ा बंद कर दो, शोर बड़ा आ रहा है। बाप यस रोल नंबर 58 नहीं है, 59 60
प्रेजेंट सर,
61
प्रेजेंट सर, 61
62 62
63 64 present sir,
64 hai aapka,
yes sir 64,
okay 65
yes sir present 65,
okay double 6
72
73 76 77 78 79
Yes sir, 79
80
Yes sir, 80
81 82 83
Yes sir, 83
84
Yes sir, 84
85
Yes, sir, 85.
86. 87.
Yes, sir, 87.
88.
Yes, sir, 88. 89.
Yes, sir, 89.
90. Yes, sir,
90.
91. Yes, sir, 91 present.
92.
92 present sir.
93
Yes sir, 93
94
Yes sir, 94
95 96
Yes sir, 96
97
Yes sir, 97
98
Yes sir, 98
99 100 101 102
Yes sir, 102
103
Yes sir, 103 104
Yes sir, 104
Anybody
else? 86
वो लाइट से लग रही थी टेनिस के
टाइम
78 अच्छा और कोई
78 ठीक है 86 सर 103 और
2016 103
2016 civil 103 ji, aur bhi repeater ya koi iske alawa
86
yes sir yeah aur 99 to aap log pehle kahan the yaar
abhi to maine bola hai aap kyun bhai sir net problem
sir wo light chali gayi
theek hai 59 bhi hai
yes sir
okay ji koi aur iske alawa repeater ya So I'm going to end this meeting over here. जैसे मैंने कहा है कि अभी मैं स्लाइड वो अपडेट कर देता हूँ जो गलती से वो दूसरी सेंड हो गई थी तो उसको आपने पढ़ना है ये रिकॉर्डिंग भी कोशिश पूरी है कि इस वीकेंड तक मैं आपको शेयर कर दूँ
सर 2016
अच्छा 2016 सिविल नाइन ओके ओके जी सो नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू एंड द मीटिंग तो नेक्स्ट टाइम मैं पूछूंगा किसने कितना पढ़ा है स्लाइड्स वगैरह डाउनलोड की है नहीं की तो उसको आपने लाजमी जो है वो देखना है 2018 R17 सिविल 95 से मैसेज किया हुआ है यू बी प्रेजेंट है आप
सर यस सर आई एम प्रेजेंट
95 Okay, जी, so we'll have another meeting next week. We'll start with another topic. उसकी मैं स्लाइड्स आपको शेयर कर दूंगा एक आध दिन तक